Hello everyone, and welcome back to another snail mail vlog. So it is that time of the week again when I have scurried over to the P.O. box, opened it up, and been completely blown away by how many letters were inside. Oh my goodness, you guys, this is amazing. So let me show you guys. All right, it's a whole big pile here. Ta-da! Look at this. This is 14 letters. And we have letters that are from local areas. We have letters from England. We've got letters from Australia. We have letters from all over the place that I'm really excited to get to. I just cannot believe that you guys have sent in so many things. So thank you so much. Thank you from the bottom of my heart for bringing this aspect of the community to life and just sharing it with everybody. Oh, it's just awesome. So I'm really excited to get to these today. And just to warn you guys, because there's like twice as much as there have been in past snail mail videos, I might have to go through them just a little bit faster just so we can cover everybody. But we're going to open all of these up. It's going to be very exciting just to see what glimpses into the lives of the community members are waiting for us today. So these are like you guys. These are like people who are just like you sending these things in. And I just think it's so exciting to see just those little hints from people. And of course, we've got our big old scrapbook here that I just wanted to show you guys, where I have put in everything from last week already, and everything has a place and everything is super awesome. I've been flipping through it. I keep it near my desk when I work so that I can look through it and get inspiration for Wolf Quest or some of our other series. I'm going to be shocked if we don't have a ton of Warrior Cats things starting to show up pretty soon. So there we go. So you guys know that our scrapbook is growing. Look how big it's gotten already. I might have to start like buying more page protectors soon. Like I buy these sheets of 100 pack page protectors and we go through them so quick. It's amazing. But yeah, that's doing good. You may notice Yarny has a new companion in the background. There's some other things hidden in the background as usual. I always hide things there for you guys to enjoy trying to find. But let's dive right in. So, okay, like I said, might have to go a little bit faster today just so that we can make sure to get to everybody. But this very first letter is from Sylph or Mindy. So let's go ahead and crack this open. And, ooh, I see there's some red color in here. Oh my goodness. Every week I get so excited. Oh my gosh, and so nervous. It's like Christmas and my birthday all at once. It's just amazing. My little hands are shaking already. Okay, let us see what is hiding in here from Mindy. Let me move my beautiful little tea mug a little bit. So there is, it's another one of the little Chinese New Year cards. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, look, it has little birds on the front. I'm gonna have to compare that. I actually have the other one up here. So look at those with the little gold and the birds, and we've got one from Taylor and now we've got one from Mindy too. Let's look at the letter before we see what's inside. That is so pretty. Ah, that makes me so excited because spring is here. I always feel like the first of the year should be like on spring, when spring starts on the 20th of March or earlier. And the 20th of March is the official spring start date, but wouldn't this just be like, here's spring and here's a beautiful gift. Like that would be perfect. All right, so let's go ahead. And it looks like we've got a few things. We've got a few little pieces right here. So let's see what's hiding in here. Oh, it's a draw. Oh, wow. Wow, you guys, look at this. Do you see all of these animals? Look at all of these. Oh my gosh, we've got deer, owls. Oh my goodness. Look at everybody. Look at all of them. Lily, Tate, look at Ash. Oh my gosh. Oh, they're so pretty. Wow. All right, let's see if there's a letter that goes with all of these. Is this another one? By Sylph. Sylph? Sylphie? Sylph? I'm going to mispronounce that. I'm so sorry. I'm so bad with pronunciation. But oh my gosh. Oh, branches of stairs. Holly has a bed like a treehouse. Oh my gosh. Feel free to add more plants. And Holly, this is an amazing idea. I'm like blown away. Okay, let's see if I can show you guys this. So you can see Squicken. You can see several different birds. You can see a tabby slime down here. Here's a phosphor slime. And then Holly in a tree. I am thinking that someone just donated for a tree and we're building Holly a bird tree, which might tie in very well with our zoo crafting series, because Holly, the bird or the dog who normally is sitting with our chickens and our squickens and our dodos and collects their eggs and like watches over them, she's been missing. And I have a little story that's going in there, but this might change the story to a whole new amazing level. So this is very, very exciting. Oh my gosh. All right, let's see. Is this the letter? Oh, wow, there's so much treasure just in one letter. It's amazing. Oh, wow. From Sylph. Let's see. Oh, my gosh. Oh, wow. This is so pretty. So Mindy used to send us, like, here's a nice little drawing. And the handwriting is fantastic. And I'm going to just kind of skim over this really quickly. So Sylph. And yeah, I remember Mindy. Mindy used to send us a lot of letters. I actually have them in our other scrapbook from last year. And tree, yep. Can you please change my tree? I feel really bad for Holly because she doesn't have much shelter from the rain. Plus, I think the dodo, squicken, chicken, and red poppy, red rose, sniffle, rest in peace, deserve some nest. And did you see the picture in the tree she drew? Look at this. It has a hanging nest in it. That is so creative. Oh my gosh, that makes me so excited. Oh my goodness. Okay, so let's see. I'm just going to kind of skim it because it's such a nice letter, and I'll read it in my own time, of course. Let's see. And I have a little legend about the carrot fish and fishing bun buns. Yes, I call them bun buns. I do too. Don't worry. Here it is. The carrot fish and the fishing bunny rabbit bun bun, your choice, are well known, but there is a fabled golden carrot fish and jade fishing bun bun. These two mythical creatures are only visible while riding a unicorn or a wyvern, placing a fishing bun bun on your head. They have been said to be able to give whoever finds them a special gift. That would be amazing to add in. We're starting to actually talk about adding in a lot more mythological creatures into the zoo crafting series, especially once we get the farming side series up and going. And that gives me so many ideas. This creativity, this is the best thing. I love seeing your guys' creativity and imaginations come to life like this. And then, yep, NPC. The vials needed for making sure we can create all the fairy horses. Tell you about myths and legends and fairy tales. Book in your hand, and strawberry and vanilla sweets. No pies, please. Put her anywhere near that's shaded from the rain and comfortable. Oh, that is so much fun. Oh, wow. So thank you so much, Sylph, Mindy. I'm gonna figure out how to pronounce your new name because that's beautiful. These are beautiful. I think I know what I'm gonna find hiding inside of here now, and I'm really excited. I feel like, especially because Darling studies like Chinese history, I feel like I need to start giving out some of these to my, yep, oh my gosh. Oh. You'll have your NPC and everything taken care of, thank you, Sadie. Oh my gosh. That's really gonna help us be able to get some of the new equipment that I've been trying to save up for the channel, so. Whew. Okay, all right, I'm gonna very gently put these over here. That is so exciting. So you guys, thank you so much, Mindy. Thank you. And I have so many ideas from what you've sent in. And thank you so much for helping out the channel. I always feel blown away when people want to do that. And thank you so much. Then I have an amazing storyline in my head now as ideas for Holly that you have just given me that I'm going to combine with the story I was kind of playing with, and we're going to turn it into something pretty amazing. So hopefully I can get that out this month too, where we'll have a whole little arc to go find where Holly has gone. Again, just because of the gentle little pushes and suggestions that you guys have sent in. So that is so cool. So okay, I already have to keep moving. Oh my goodness. So thank you so much, Mindy. The art is beautiful. The gift is so deeply appreciated, and the inspiration for the stories that we are going to tell is just phenomenal. So, all right, I feel so weird having to move faster, but we're already like 10 minutes in, and I've hardly like started to peck through the pile. So, forgive me if I'm kind of clipping along, but we're going to clip along so that we can give everybody a little bit of time to say thank you and just to see what's going on. All right, so you can open it on video and read it out. Oh, and it has a little heart. Look at that. So this is one of them that is from Gatwick. So let's see. This one is from over there, Royal Mail, which is always very exciting, which is probably like so mundane to people who actually get the Royal Mail all the time. But over here, it's like, ooh, that's so fancy. Royal Mail. Oh my gosh. All right. Very gently opening that up. And let's see what's hiding inside. We've got some little letters right here. So let's see. Let's open this one up first. Looks like a nice, big, beautiful letter. Dear Seri, I know you love swans at the moment on zoo crafting because of the lake or because of the Tate and Tackle. I was wondering if you can name one of the white swans Petra, because I have a swan living on my lake and she comes to my front door and pecks on the windows for food. She is like our pet. That's amazing. I cannot imagine how cool that would be if you just had a swan wander up and like peck at your door like, hey, where's the food today? Hello. That's kind of like what the chickadees do on my window here. They'll like kind of peck at it like, you know, you haven't put new bird seed out lately, Seri. What's going on? That is so fun. I also have a pet duck called Charlie. I hatched him from an egg, and then I became a mummy to him, and he would never leave my side when I was walking. If I went away from him for too long, he would panic and quack very loudly. He's very funny. Hope you get this letter from Becca. P.S. Love your videos. Thank you so much, Becca. Oh my gosh, that'll be such a fun swan name. Every time I look at that swan in zoo crafting, I'm gonna think about you now. That is adorable. Ooh, look at you. Oh wow, it's Rain. Oh, this is so cool. So this is Rain from our Wolf Quest series. I almost said zoo crafting. From Wolf Quest. Rain was the leader of the Stormy Skies pack. Here's her little turn ear and everything. And her redder muzzle that she had. She kind of had a lot of red coloration in her fur. And look at this. So it says, sorry about the scratch, but that's actually perfect. We could act like she just fought off a coyote and defended her pups or did something like that. Rain was definitely one of my favorite wolves that we've had so far. And it was such an honor to like see her story unfold. It was so tragic and so touching all at the same time. So I love to have some more art for her. Thank you so much, Becca. Oh my gosh. I'm so happy. Thank you. Thank you so much. And how fun to get more mail from overseas too. That's always such a special thing. Oh, and like I said, forgive me if I seem to be clipping along. I just want to make sure we can get to everybody. All right, so we have Anna Moore, or Anna, and I almost said last name. Sorry about that. I try not to do that. But look at this. Plants for forever, and there's cute little drawings on the front. I love that. I actually keep the envelopes that a lot of people send if they have like drawings or anything on them. I keep them and I just put them behind the drawings in the page protectors. So like I try not to waste any of your creativity, trust me. All right, now this one is well taped. So give me just a moment here because I try to open them so careful so I don't hurt anything that might be hiding on the inside. All right. Let's see. Oh, wait. I think this one has a thing that's written on the under of the envelope. Okay, let's turn it like this. Aha. Aha! Read this on camera, please. Thanks, Seri. See, that's a creative way to tell me where to do it. Hint, I normally, tear it along the line up here, but I saw that there was a message. That's kind of fun, like a hidden message for me. Oh, what's this? Just what do we have here? Hang on now. Oh, that's so cute. Russell Stover note. Oh, I'm going to have to show Chips that. It's a little Russell Stover note. Oh my gosh. Hey Seri, P.S. Next time you are on the zoo crafting, tell the others hi for me. From AnimalLover242. I totally will. I'm going to show Chips that too, aka Darling, because Russell Stover makes so much good chocolate. So let's see what's going on over here. All right, hang on. I got to wiggle it open. And, oh, there's so many dogs. Oh, it's Rain! It's poor Rain who we were just talking about. She did have a lot of very tragic stories when all of her puppies died. And well, not all of them, but you know, you'll have to watch Wolf Quest to understand how dramatic it got. But let's see what we've got here. Dear Seri, thank you so much for showing my letter in snail mail. I was stressed out and it totally cheered me up. Oh, and on the other side of the page are some names for Wolf Quest or zoo crafting. They are the names of my three dogs who we gave away. Oh, I'm so sorry to hear about that. That is always hard when you have to give some of your animals away. And we have Brownie, who is a black dog, hyper at times and loving. Charlie, who is a black dog, hyper all of the time and wants to please. And Shadow, who is a black dog and looks like a skunk. Very hyper and tries to get out of places. Due to jumping the fence all the time, we had to give him away. And that does happen sometimes. We've had dogs where, like, there were great dogs, just the situation wasn't ideal. And the most important thing is you always do what's right for the animal. So don't, I know it's hard, but don't worry. All right, so let's see. Why do you not play on Time Shot? I liked it. And I actually am not working on Time Shot anymore because I don't like vanilla Minecraft. And it was a really hard choice because I love the people there. Wynn is still on our server. You know, Mara started out on Zoo Crafting and then she came to Time Shot and that was super exciting. And she's still there. Huck is still on both. Anasia's still on both. So there's a lot of overlap. And I still consider myself friends with all of those people. And it's really fun to keep up with everybody and what they're doing on Time Shot. I started out on modded Minecraft and it's so hard for me to give up my plants and Pam's harvest craft and the extra animals and butterflies that in the end I just couldn't do it because I love modded Minecraft, and vanilla Minecraft just, it felt like pulling teeth. it didn't have that same sense of like adventure and excitement. I couldn't customize NPCs to do trades. I couldn't have like just crop fields growing all over the place. So I did retire from TimeShot a few months ago, actually. We had a little announcement about it, but it was kind of like just a quiet thing. So that's why. Big Farm is a game you can join cooperatives, and it has chat so all the community can talk and share ideas. That makes me want to try out Farmville 2 again. It's been a long time since I have been there. Oh, gosh. And there we go. So thank you so much, Anna. Oh, I'm so excited. And here's another little picture of Wrenn. Poor Wrenn. She had such a sad life sometimes. And I'll write down your list of names. We have, like, a huge list. I actually, like, is one loose? Nope, I don't have any loose pages to show you you guys the list, but I do have huge lists of names. So thank you so much. And poor Wrenn. I'm so glad that she has had her story end as neatly as it has, though, because it was really an amazing story. All right, and we have one from Charles Heron, or Charles H. Sorry, I need to get better at not doing that. And we've got an awesome drawing of me on the back. Look at that, my little flower. I love my little flower in the hair. Okay, so let's see what Charles from, I can't remember, Nebraska, there we go. I was like, I know what that abbreviation stands for. For those of you guys who don't know, in the United States, we abbreviate our states just with like two letters. And because there's 50 of them, sometimes it can take me a second to remember which one of the abbreviations stands for what. All right, gently putting that there. And let's see what's going on. Oh, it's another cute drawing. Look at that. I love how long my hair is in that one. Let's see. So much to do in the zoo. That is the truth. Oh my gosh. All right. Oh, Charlie, I think Charlie just sent me a letter today asking me if I had gotten this. So let's see. Dear Seri, my name is Charlie. I love your videos. You can learn from them and you can have fun watching them. My favorite series you have done are Zoo Crafting, Slime Rancher, and Spore Tooth and Claw, which I need to do more of soon. I love your channel and you are the one who inspired me to be a biologist. Your friend, Charlie. Thank you so much. I love hearing that I've inspired people to like work hard in school or to like try to study biology or the sciences or just appreciate plants more or go on a walk or just play with their pets more. And I think one of the really fun secrets is that when you want to become a biologist or you want to do something like that, it really is important to do well in school no matter what class you're taking. It doesn't matter if it's art, it doesn't matter if it's music, PE, any of those things. The grades will give you the opportunities in the future, and you never know what you're going to learn from them. I would have never guessed my computer programming class would eventually give me a way to run a YouTube channel and then share all of this with you guys. So never turn your back on opportunities to learn, guys, especially just because you need the grades, if nothing else, to make the opportunities that you want to study. So that little PSA aside, look at that. Look at the cuties. Look at the little tabby slime. And we have Lily and Tate and another really nice drawing. That is some well done hair there, Charlie. So thank you so much. I'm so glad you enjoy those series. It is a good reminder of me to make sure to check in on our Spore Tooth and Claw series. And I will very gently tuck that into our scrapbook for sure. So thank you so much. All right. I know. I'm sorry. I have to keep moving because there's so many people. So this is a snail mail. Look at the little one. There's a little snail there. And this is from Megan, and I think she's from Arizona. So let's go ahead and gently open this. Oh, so gently, so I don't tear my little snail in the back. And, ooh, this is very thick paper. Let's see what's hiding over here. It's like a little treasure. You never know what you're gonna find. Random treasure everywhere. Oh my gosh, it's so pretty. Look at the giraffe. Look at the little giraffe. Can you guys see the giraffe? Look at that giraffe. Oh my gosh. And then we've got a cat right here named Lily. A very good name. I highly approve of the name of Lily. And let's see. Good. I can read this out loud. Dear Seri, I love watching your videos and learning about a lot about our world. Please keep up the good work. From Megan. Oh, and she has fun facts and a koi fish. Look how pretty this koi fish is. Oh, can I focus on it? There we go. Little koi fish right there. Fun facts. Koi fish can reach up to 3 feet long. Giraffes have one of the shortest sleep requirements. They can sleep from 10 minutes to 2 hours a day. That is really cool. I think I knew they didn't sleep a lot, but I had no idea it was that little. That is so cool. A giraffe tongue can be as long as 45 centimeters. A group of cats is called a clouder. I'm going to have to remember that for a warrior cat series. So it's not called a clan, you guys. It's called a clouder. Cats have over 20 muscles that control their ears. Oh, and that cute drawing of Lily. Oh, there's a carrot fish, you guys. There's a carrot fish. So we have a carrot fish right here, which, as you guys know, we just had a carrot fish exhibit built. So that was very exciting. We have a carrot bun right here. Oh, how fun. And we just read some carrot bun facts yesterday, too. Oh, my goodness. And then here we have Zeus from our Twin Barktown series, which I haven't given up on. I just needed to be on hiatus till I'm not so panicky about doing it again. Oh, look at this. And then we have got Sunflower. Oh my gosh, it's when Sunflower got lost in the canyon. Look at her fight off the spiders. Here's my grave. Here we are with Aster Seed flying in to rescue her. That is so cool. Oh my goodness. Wow, and there's little gemstones in the side for the cavern and the little tiny details. You guys know how much I love little tiny details. And there's little tiny details in the leaves here. Oh, how fun. And then this is that story. Remember the story we read off? Did you write this story? This is so fun. So, Megan, did you write this story? With the story of when the water gardens filled up the area so much around the Tate and Tackle that we got stuck in it. And Tate had to come and we had to be rescued by Pablo, I think it was, had to rescue us. Or Alex or Ben, I can't remember who it was who rescued us. But they came in and rescued us from the overgrown water gardens. So we might have to look out. That would actually be really fun to have like random events that could happen in zoo crafting. And it's like the water gardens have overgrown again. That might be something we do in the future. So thank you so much. I love all of this art. Oh my gosh. Very gently going to collect it up and put it right over here. Megan, thank you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I love seeing your guys' creativity come to life. I know I say that again and again, but I mean it from the bottom of my heart. That's the best thing about what we do. Oh my goodness. All right, so, oh my gosh, I don't even think we've gone halfway there. I'm trying, guys. I'll go a little faster. So we have Rylan B from Canada. So this is from Canada. Oh my gosh. please read on camera, which I know you will do since you are awesome, amazing. Oh, thank you so much. So from Rylan. All right, and I'm gonna gently wiggle this open. From Canada, no less. Oh my gosh, we're getting all over the world today. Oh my gosh, this envelope won't open. Oh my goodness. Okay, give me just a second. I have to wiggle over here and wiggle up and wiggle over. And what do we have here? We've got something going on down here. Ooh, look at this. All right, what do we have here? It's a thank you letter that's really cute. It looks kind of like the ones I have. The ones I have are full of owls. Hi, Seri. I'm Rylan from Canada, eh? Just thank you for being such an amazing and funny person. Oh my gosh. And your amazing zoo crafting season has given me an idea. Since you are going to give each dog a part of the zoo, can you please make Iris have a flower shop since Iris is a flower? Oh my gosh. Thank you, Seri. You're amazing. Thank you so much, Rylan. A flower shop for Iris would actually be perfect for her. I could almost see her happily retiring to the flower shop because she doesn't really like adventures. She drowns every time she goes near any water. So I could see Iris being very, very happy having a little flower shop to be in. And that sounds like a perfect idea. Someone else mentioned that Ash should have like an archaeology tent. So I think we're finally starting to line everybody up. Tate with the Tate and Tackle, Lily with her Wisteria gazebo and cafe. And then Iris can have a flower shop. Holly is probably going to end up having a giant bird tree, which is going to be so cool. And we'll just work our way through that. That is going to be so much fun. I wonder what Pine will do. Pine's puppy daycare, perhaps? What do you guys think about that? All right, and then we have a drawing right here. Seri, you are amazing. Click here to subscribe to Seri Pixel Biologist. And here are some YouTube buttons showing you that you are the best YouTuber ever. Oh, thank you. Thank you, Rylan. That's really fun because actually when you're a YouTuber, a mark of your success with getting subscribers, which is, you know, that doesn't always mean you're successful and that doesn't always mean you have a great channel, but it might mean you worked hard, is getting a silver YouTube button when you get to 100,000 people, and you get a gold YouTube button that's like, I think it's like this freaking big, it's huge from the pictures I've seen, when you get to 1,000,000 people. I have no idea if we ever get to the gold. It'd be really nice if we could get to silver, but the most important thing to me is that we have an amazing community that can learn so much from each other. So, oh my gosh, so, okay. Deep breath. Arnold from what I think is Vermont. I really need to work on my state abbreviation. So this is from Arnold. I'm going to very carefully open it up so we don't hurt anything that might be hiding inside. And let's see what Arnold has sent us. All right, let's open this puppy up. Ooh, this is pretty. Ooh, we've got like several pages. All right, hang on now. Let me see where we start. Ah, thank you. And this one also says I can read this on air. Thank you. Dear Seri, I love your videos. They make me smile whenever I see them. Thank you for that, Seri. Oh, there's pictures. Look at the little pictures of the wolves drawn up here, too. That is so pretty. Wow. Wolf Quest. I like how you are always excited. It makes watching your videos even better. I draw a lot and make a lot of art for your Wolf Quest. The next part is a suggestion. You may read it if you like. I was wondering if you could do a Wolf Quest episode where a wolf gets caught by humans and taken to the fenced place in Lost River. You can get in here by running to the left side of the fenced off area. After you go that way, look at the bottom of the scent moat wall, you'll see a gap. So, that actually could be an interesting challenge that we could have for an ancestor challenge. So I will remember that. Thank you so much. All right, hang on just a second, Arnold. I need to see what these ones are. So Wolf Quest, those are beautiful wolves. Oh, wow, those are beautiful wolves. So let's see what you enjoy from a Wolf Quest. Oh, and I love the challenges you guys come up with too. Oh, wow, holy days. Oh, so this is Luna, and then it says, I'm so happy to see you, and my love, I missed you too, and I wonder if this is the wolves who have passed away, and they are now ancestors, and we get their ancestor dreams that we follow. Look at the lines and the colors on that, you guys. Isn't that just precious? Look at the posture of the wolves in the background. That is just gorgeous. Arnold, this is beautiful. This is really beautiful. Oh my gosh, and I love that. And Luna, I never imagined way back when I was fighting in Wolf Quest 2.5 with the awful controls that were having a horrible time on my computer, I never imagined that it would end up becoming something that meant so much to so many people, and that really has changed my life. And I'm really glad I stuck with it and that you guys have enjoyed it so much. All right, let me take a quick little peek at this. Oh, this is eclipsing Luna again. Oh my gosh. Yes, okay, I'm going to be reading these. I see this says please read off camera, so I will do it off camera. But there's a little fanfic of when Luna and Eclipse saw each other again. So that's really precious because Eclipse is Luna's son, actually. So that's so sweet. That is really sweet. Oh, thank you so much, Arnold. Oh my gosh. All right, so let's see. This is from Australia. This is one of the ones from Australia. It doesn't have a name. It might have said something on the bottom, and I'm afraid they have taped over it. So it says a mystery. It just feels like opening up a bunch of mysterious little packages. All right, let's wiggle in here. I got this. Don't you guys worry. Hey, meerkat, come back. All right, and I have a little meerkat on my screen today, which is really cute. All right, so this one's from Australia. Gentle, gentle, gentle. Wiggle this open. And there's a lot of paper in here. Okay, where to start? Let's see. What does this paper say? This paper says nothing. This paper is empty. This paper is a mystery. Maybe it's invisible ink. I wonder if I need to do something, pour some tea on it or something to reveal what it might say. It might be there for padding, which is a good idea if you're sending something from another country, especially Australia. I find the stuff from Australia tends to get bumped around a little bit more than the stuff from Canada or Europe. Oh, this is so cool! Look at this zoo crafting picture! Look at this! We have a werewolf up here. We've got a little cotton bun. Over here, we've got a sand cat. Oh, we need to make the sand cat exhibit. That is going on my to-do list, like ASAP. We have the macaw. Oh, look at the magpies. Oh, a giant fruit fox. The carrot fish. I am in love with the carrot fish, you guys. And we have a peacock. Oh my gosh, look at that color. That is so cool. Oh, I love that. Especially the magpies, which you guys in Australia are probably much more familiar with than me. That is so fun. All right, let's make sure I line it all up. I want to make sure I keep everything together with who's supposed to be together. So I'm going to, here we go. There we go. Now I'm going to make sure I know whose letter belongs to who very carefully. And then, all right, let's see what's going on here. We've got, it's a book. It's a little book. Look at this, you guys. So it's a little animal book. And it says on the back, from Jordan. Thanks for being an awesome YouTuber, Seri. Thank you so much, Jordan. It really is the opportunity to share my excitement about the world, about storytelling, adventures, just digging into my imagination, curiosity, that makes this so awesome. So we've got an animal book here. It's got page numbers and it's got like little drawings of the animals and descriptions of what they do inside. Rainbow lorikeet. Oh, there's a leatherback turtle. Look at this. I think these are like, so I can learn more about the taipan, more about creatures in Australia. The thorny devil. I wish we had a thorny devil. That would be so much fun. Electric eel. That's South America. The Atlantic puffin, the African striped skink. These are so cool. cool. I wish I had done stuff this cool when I was younger. I don't think I did things that were this cool. Capybara! I love capybara! They're like one of my favorite things on this entire planet because they're just adorable. A little bank vole. Oh, wow. A common skate, a finless porpoise, which I was just reading about, actually. This is awesome. I wish I could show my nieces and my cousins so that they could get some inspiration from this. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my gosh. All right. And that's Jordan. I have to remember. So that's Jordan. And then it looks like, oh, yeah, this is a cool letter. All right. And Jordan, I am going to be, he's 13. Lives in Sunshine Coast in Queensland, Australia. I love watching your videos, especially zoo crafting. I love animals and dinosaurs, and you might already know from past emails and Facebook messages, plants, nature, and Minecraft, so the whole idea of building a zoo in Minecraft is amazing. I have been watching zoo crafting since season 1, episode 331, where you hatched the golden chocobo chickens. Of course, I went back over and watched 330 episodes before it as well. Anyway, I think the whole idea of having a community that helps one another and builds amazing zoos and saves wildlife is just awesome. To be honest, I sometimes dream about what it would be like to play on a server where my part of the world would be. If that's what I dream about, then you must be really inspiring. And you are. I also love Zoo Tycoon, mostly because of the animals. Where I live in Australia has many animals, probably because of the temperature and the lush environment. My favorite animal that lives around here is the green tree frog. I can't wait until amphibians get added into the zoo, and that is a good point. I need to add amphibians into the zoo. There's so many frogs we could use. I hope you enjoy this letter and have a great day and night. Sincerely yours, Jordan. Thank you so much, Jordan. Oh my goodness. That is so exciting, and to be able to hear from people on a whole other part of the planet who you guys experience animal life, flora, and fauna so differently than I do here, it really makes me want to go adventuring one day. One day I really want to go out and adventure this world and be able to share some of that with you guys too. All right, I know, Birdos, I know I need to go a little bit faster. This is your Jessie checklist. That is so fun. Oh, this is the checklist that we do in our zoo crafting series. The Red Wolf Tavern and Hotel, the Bat Cave, Swan Lake, Dr. Nami's Underwater Observatory, the Tate and Tackle. And I really do want to work on that checklist. It is sometimes a little hard to do a daily series, I won't lie, especially when your energy varies from day to day. But seeing all this stuff, seeing zoo crafting come to life from what you guys have shown me, just it puts some sort of really special energy in you that makes you realize how, even though it just feels some days like you're a little tired and you don't know what to do, if you can just stick to the things and talk about your natural excitement about the world, I think we're gonna have so many more years of amazing adventures in zoo crafting. And I promise I'm gonna try to pick up the pace with the exhibits too, especially because I would love to get it to the point where we could like have a poster that's like a zoo map. That would be really awesome, but I realize that means I have to actually start building exhibits, so we're gonna be working on those too. But thank you so much, that is just so awesome. I love the art, I love all of the ideas, I love that animal book. Oh, thank you so much. And oh my goodness, we still have a bit to go through, so I'm gonna go a little bit faster. I keep saying that, but all right. Deep breath, 1 second, you guys. And all right, there we go. Just had to make sure that you don't get cut off by my camera going, it's been 30 minutes, Siri, what are you doing? So here we go. We are reading from Texas. So this is a letter from Texas. I actually lived in Texas for many, many years. And let's see. Dear Siri, you are welcome to read it aloud on your video, but will you please read it yourself as soon as possible? I have suggestions that might need to be read soon. And I actually just picked this letter up yesterday. So hopefully I haven't missed out on the suggestions that need to be read soon. Very carefully opening the envelope. Oh, don't hurt the things inside. Don't hurt the things inside. All right, gently, gently, gently. Here we go. All right, there we go. And let's see what's hiding in here. So we're going to very carefully put that there. Oh, look at the color. You guys, look at this. Ooh, that's a nice waxy material too. So here, look at that. With the little flower, a little winking face, my little zoo outfit. Oh, look at those flowers. That is so pretty. Wow. All right. So let's see who this is from and what suggestions we might have. Dear Siri, my name is Georgia and I live in Texas. I enjoy theater, wildlife, and spending time with my friends and family. I love to read, write books, and go to the park with my friends and watch the geese swim by. When I heard you were going to make a series based on the warrior books, I was thrilled, and we have. We started that last week and it has taken off, and I have actually reordered the entire first series. I'm going to reread all of the books, and the library was like, there's a 14-person waiting list. So I was just like, So I just ordered the entire paperback first series, and I'm going to work my way through that, and then the second series. And the first and second series were the only Warrior books that were out when I started reading them 10, 13 years ago when they first came out. So I didn't even know there were more than that after that. So I'm going to be catching up on a lot of the books and hopefully learning a lot about the Warriors. So let's see what we have to say about the Warriors in here. I started the books a few weeks back and have already bonded with the cats. I really enjoy your channel and the Warrior books, so this is a perfect match. If it would work with your story, I would like for a cat to be added into this description. A cat born from Mossleaf's clan or a wild cat that comes to her clan. I would prefer it be a she-cat, but this is not too important. If a clan, if clan born, this kit is named Ivy Kit. If born in the wilderness and joined when around 6 months old, I would like his or her name to be Ivy Paw. I would like you to decide the backstory and personality. Again, I am so excited about the series, and I can definitely add that name to the list. You guys have blown me away with how many name suggestions there are. I actually have a Word document that's up to 340 something odd, like I added more this morning, names that you guys have sent in, and I'm trying to go through and like double check for any repeats, but we're definitely going to have a lot of cats. I have a feeling just deep in my bones that the Warrior Cats series that we've started is going to last a very long time. I am building random generators online for it. I am like digging through all of the Sims things. I'm writing down, I have a list, and actually I'll show you on the update vlog tomorrow, but I have a list of all of the things that you can collect in Sims 3, and I'm like correlating them with what they can do for the animals in the Warrior Cats series, so it's gonna be fantastic. But I will definitely add that name in. Thank you so much. On another note, I have yet another suggestion. Sorry if this is too long. Now back to the letter. If you have any time, I would like for you to play Animal Jam. Continued on the next page, right over here. And Animal Jam is requested so often. I may try that someday. I'm just way overwhelmed with everything we're doing right now. And don't ever worry about sending in tons of suggestions. This is a special kind of special energy that I get from doing this that I absolutely adore. I play a lot, and I do mean a lot. My username is BasilCat. I also just got a YouTube account for Animal Jam and some other RPG games. I don't have many subs yet, but I only have had it about a week. My name is Pixel Animal. I really enjoy your channel, and I'm a huge fan. I probably should have put this paragraph at the beginning of the letter, but oh well. I have been a huge fan for a while now, and can't wait for new posts and for you to read this. I have had a lot of fun writing this. I hope you enjoyed this as much as I enjoyed writing this. Goodbye for now. Your friend, Georgia. P.S. My favorite animal is the orangutan. Georgia, you're in for a treat, because we actually have orangutan footage, and I didn't know it at the time, but the orangutan we saw at the Kansas City Zoo that I got a lot of footage of, we have footage from the orangutans at the St. Louis Zoo that I'm going to be putting up as like specimen spotlights at some point in the future too. The one at the St. Louis Zoo actually had a baby with her that she was taking care of, and the one at the Kansas City Zoo, she was eating lettuce, and I was just kind of spending the morning sitting next to her, like she was on the other side of the glass, I was sitting next to her, and apparently she was pregnant, so they just announced that she is going to have a baby in May, and you'll be able to see some orangutans in those specimen spotlights coming up, so that's going to be so cool, and good luck with your channel. I remember I started out, I think I had maybe like, I don't know, 300 views total for the first 8 months I had my channel, so it was, it's all just about passion, pushing yourself to try to develop more skills, and honestly, investing in a good mic. That's like one of the most important things you can do, I've learned. All right, so we have Evelyn from Arizona, Atlanta, and this is from Pished Muppet. So, oh, let's see, Alabama, there we go. See, I've really got to work on getting all of the little abbreviations down. So let's see what this has to say, my friend. Oh, that's Viva Pinata. I haven't forgotten about Viva Pinata. It's right here. You guys have seen in the update vlogs. I'm like, the Xbox 360 is literally not under my foot because this belongs to Chips. I wouldn't put my feet on it, but it's down here, like right below. So yeah, the Xbox 360 is here. I have not forgotten about Viva Pinata. Just way overwhelmed because, man, the Warrior Cat series is amazing. It's amazing. And doing daily zoo crafting and daily wolf quests and so many other things. Oh my gosh. Dear Seri, please read this out loud. You have made me so happy with all of the great videos. I have a YouTube channel called Evelyn5000. I don't have many subscribers, and it would be a dream to come, dream come true if you subscribed. I love plants. My favorite flowers are irises because it's my middle name, because my middle name is Iris. That's so fun! What a beautiful middle name, and what a beautiful plant. I really love irises too, especially bearded irises. They have like such cool ruffles on them. I love how you know about the Warrior Cats books. Have you read them? Like I mentioned, I have the first two series, and only the first two series because they were the only ones out. Like when I was reading them, I would buy them as soon as they were new. And then I think I went to college, like at the end of the second series, and then I just wasn't able to actually have money to get them. I remember seeing them like at Walmart, and I was like, oh, there's a new Warrior Cats book. And then you're like looking at the beans and the notebook paper that you get to spend with your tiny money that you have in college, and it's like, yeah, I don't have any money for getting a book right now. So I'm really excited that now, all these years later, I can get back into the series, because it doesn't matter if it's meant for like a younger audience. It's a story, and all stories have a lot of value, and all stories can be used as interpretations or as inspiration for amazing creations of our own, like the Warrior Cat series we're running. So yes, I have read some of the books, not all of them. I need to reread them. It's been over 12, like it's been 13 years since they first started coming out. There we go. There are others that Aaron Hunter wrote. The Seekers is about bears, and Survivors is about dogs. And I probably will be reading the Survivors and seeing if we do a Survivors a Sims 3 series in the future, too. I hope you like the fan art from Pished Muffet. And then we have Rain. Oh, we got shelf mushrooms! We have Tigers, Moondancer, Fern. Oh, and then Holly, the most wanted dog, Sunflower, the Zoo Craft. Oh, you guys, look, there's mushrooms, and there's a little fish. Isn't that awesome? Oh, that is so awesome. Oh my gosh, and there's stuff on the back too. Melody Warrior from Star Stable. We have all of the slimes, the delicate flower puddle slimes in here. Look at this. Oh my gosh. Thank you so much, Muffet. This is beautiful. This is fantastic. This is what I love. This is what I love. Oh, so thank you. Thank you so much. Oh my gosh. So yes. Yes, I'm very excited about the Warrior Cat series. I am very happy it has launched, and I'm very excited to share more of it with you. And we have a tabby slime waiting for us right here. Oh, look at that little one. I just scared off a chickadee. A chickadee. There's a bird feeder right behind you guys, and I held it up, and the chickadee is like, whoa, and it took off. That's adorable. All right, so we have one from Lauren M. in Illinois. So let's very gently open this one up, too, and see what might be hiding inside. So very gently here. Okay, I'm going to put this there. All right, you can read this if you want. Dear Seri, thank you. I never learned so much about animals without your facts. I knew I had a passion for animals, especially birds and horses. I can go on and on about them, but did you know that the chicken is the closest living relative to the T-Rex? I didn't know that. Yes, I do, because people love chicken. I love chickens. I was going to say people love T-Rex, and I love chickens, and somehow the melding of the two things, I had learned that. Isn't that such a cool fact? I'm so excited you know about it, too. If you didn't know, let's see, it was actually the person who suggested you turn your diamond armor into the leaf armor texture. I never smiled so hard from that video, and that was so helpful when I needed to like wash the armor and get it repaired in Zoo Crafting. It's kind of an obscure reference in case you don't get it, but I had to repair the armor, and there's a dishwasher in our modded Zoo Crafting, and I didn't have like the actual ability to wash my leaf armor because it was also modded, and then Ben fixed it. But until then, I replaced the textures on my diamond armor with the leaf crafting armor, and that was a brilliant move. So fantastic. I am a 14-year-old girl known as My Little Pony a Lover 789. I am on Horsehaven, Minecraft, and Slime Rancher. I love your YouTube series so much. I hope you enjoy the Leo horse skin I made you. I do! I have that! I have that saved for... I was trying to figure out... I saved it and I wasn't able to figure out like where I got it from. I was like, crap, how do I like say thank you to this person? Because I don't remember where I got it from. But I have it saved on my computer. We are going to be blending Horsehaven, and we are going to be blending a special horse breeding in our farming aside series for Zoo Crafting. So that's probably not going to come out till like April, May. But once it goes, it's going to be another one of those regular series we have all the time. And we are going to be doing some special horse breeding. So that's very exciting. And we're going to be blending Horsehaven horses and the horses in Minecraft. So it's going to be pretty fun. I don't have a Tumblr, Facebook, or Skype. So I will type in My Little Pony Lover 789 at the end of my suggestions. And you do have a Libra. She's in one of my grand stables. Oh, thank you so much. Okay, that is fantastic. Look at this tabby. Look at that puddle slime. Oh, and then look in here. Oh my gosh, we've got Aquarius horses, and we have what looks to be possibly Sunflower and Aster Seed right there, and so many slimes just jumping all over the place, and Willow on her nest. Willow on her nest. That is so fine. Oh, thank you so much, My Little Pony Lover. That is just adorable, beautiful, elegant lines too. I am just blown away by how many of you are able to draw such like awesome, gentle lines. All right, and then we have Nico and Danny, all right, from New Jersey. So let's see what this is. Let's see what this is. Let's go ahead. Let's see. We've got three letters left, including this one. So this has quite a bit. I wonder if this is a brother-sister group, which or a sibling set group. We often get letters from sibling sets, which is really fun. And then read me first, read me second. All right, so let's see. Let's see what's going on here. All right. Dear Seri, I am a huge fan of your channel, and I draw a lot of inspiration from it. I mostly watch Zoo Crafting, Slime Rancher, and Spore, but I sometimes look for something new. I wanted to know, what mod does the Zookeeper experience points come from? And that is actually a retexture of the broken orbs in the custom NPC mod. So the broken orbs are a item that you can't craft in the world, you can't find in the world, you have to get only from creative. So I just yanked it, changed the texture so that it looked like a little zookeeper paw, and made that into the zookeeper experience points. So you're not able to find them, you only can earn them from NPCs. So there's the secret behind the zookeeper experience points paws. It's just a pixel item that I made, and then I edited it so that it would override some of the textures. I hope wherever you move to, you and Chips are comfortable and happy. And thank you so much. And I really need to get the vlogging channel up and going. I'm hoping maybe I can even find time to do that this weekend, even just a short little update video, because getting ready to figure out where we're moving is a really fun adventure, and I would love to share some of that with you guys. Finally, may I suggest, either for the farming series or the farm in Zoodesia, a horse racing track. Sincerely, Nico. Please excuse the randomness of the letter. I'm not good with writing letters. Not random at all. Absolutely awesome. I love hearing that range of suggestions and just knowing the full expanse of what you guys love so much. And a horse racing track would be fantastic, especially if I could get our friends to come over. Maybe try a horse out. Maybe have a horse of their own that they could keep at our horse stables. And we could race. We could have defensing like trophies that we could give each other. That would be really cool. All right, and then let's see. I hope you have fun and make new friends at your new house. I hope Dr. Nami, Junior, Lily, Tate, Iris, Pine, and all the others are doing well. May I suggest you open a store called The Mine Mart that sells ores, armor, seeds, dog accessories, and all sorts of other things. Sincerely, Danny. Danny, that sounds like a really good idea. The Mine Mart. You know, Pablo just started building Mine Kia for furniture, so it would be really fun just to have somewhere that was called, like, The Mine Mart, and it focused on all of those ores that we have in Zoo Crafting that can be really hard to find sometimes. I'm pretty sure, especially Wrenn would appreciate if we had somewhere to go just to buy the ore that we needed if we can't find it in the wild. So I will look into doing that. So thank you so much, Nico. All right. And then, ooh, fancy fonts. Oh, wow. Oh my gosh, Nico, I'm going to read this on my own because we've been going on for almost an hour now. But this is so cool. You guys, this is a journal entry from Slime Rancher. So this is Nico from the Far, Far Range Explorer. This is fantastic. So it's calculations, founding the snow gate or the stone gate, the moss blanket, stalactites hanging from the ceiling, the giant's other eye opened, and it moved slightly, vines and trees snapping. Then I noticed the smaller, normal-sized slimes, then calmed them, poured a bit of water onto the honey, released its grip on the slimes. Oh, this is so cool! This is like an entry, this is a journal entry of exploring in the Slime Rancher area. You guys, I cannot wait until Slime Rancher updates and we get more areas to explore. It's a series I really wish there was more customization ability in so that we could just keep it going forever, because it is so much fun to see how much you guys just adore Slime Rancher and all of the, like, this is really, really a creative original idea, and all of the original slimes you guys come up with. I'm gonna do my best. We might have to wait till the full game releases in fall to really throw ourselves hardcore into Slime Rancher again, but we're gonna be following the updates, and just to see this kind of creativity is so cool. So thank you so much, Nico. Oh my gosh, and we've still got more. Oh, elder shrines and shroom slimes. Oh, you guys, look at this. Those custom slimes again. I am gonna have to make an account and just share this on the official Slime Ranches, because this is like rancher form, because these are all so amazing. Wow, imagine a giant slime like that and the little shroom slimes living on top of it. That is so cute. Are there more slimes in here? Like, oh, are there more slimes? Let's see. Oh, it's Mine Mart. So the logo for Mine Mart. That would be really fun. It actually makes me think of Stardew Valley quite a bit. And that's a good thing. Anything that inspires me to think about Stardew Valley is a very good thing. And then Here's another sign. So Mine Mart, ores, armors, seeds, accessories, and more. Doo-doo-doo, Mine Mart. There we go. That is so cool. That is so cool. Oh my gosh. All the inspiration and the ideas. And just as much as you guys get inspiration ideas from our episodes, I get it from you guys. It feeds into each other. I've talked about that in vlogs before, how I think that's one of the most fantastic aspects of doing this, is that it's a positive growth cycle. You guys get creativity, you give me creativity. You guys get happiness, and just your happiness gives me happiness, and that's the awesome thing. Kindness and creativity are really things that I feel like are just, if you generate more of one, you just get more of it. It doesn't pour, you don't use it up. You just make more and more and more of it. When you give someone kindness, it just makes them have more kindness to give to others. When you give like yourself room to grow in a creative way, it just inspires more creativity. It's amazing. All right, so we've got a couple letters left. I promise I'll go a little faster because, oh my gosh, I can't believe we've really been doing this for almost an hour. I'm sorry, guys. All right, Lizzie from Ohio, I think. Yay, right on camera, look at that. Oh, the chickadee's back. All right, let's see. Very gently here from Lizzie. Let's see what's going on. Oh, show on camera, it says. All right, so, ooh, there's color. Ooh, there's color. Oh boy, oh my. There's color, all right. Oh, look at that, the chickadee got scared off again. Look at that, look how pretty. Oh, there's a tiny slime in there, oh my gosh. All right. So let's see. Dear Seri, I just wanted to say hi, and I want you to know you are the best YouTuber ever, and I want to ask if Twin Bark Town is coming back, and it will be. It's just on hiatus because it takes me up to 12 hours to make a single episode, and when I'm trying to put like so many other series on at once, that was way too overwhelming, so I'm working on that. But I am not abandoned Twin Bark Town, and I'm actually thinking about changing it in a way that will make it even better. So let's see. And in Twin Bark Town, I was the person with the hamster that was adopted. I've also been watching your vids for 2 or 3 years now. Oh my goodness, isn't that amazing? We've been around together that long. Oh, I'm so glad you've been with us the whole time. Thank you so much. Oh, wow. You have inspired me so much. I recently got a new cat. She is the best thing ever that has ever happened to me. Oh, so wonderful. It's all because you introduced me to how animals can be so interesting and awesome. Also, I wanted to say that my favorite series is Slime Rancher. Anyways, I just needed to say that you are the most amazing, inspirational person I've ever met. Stay curious and awesome, Seri, from Lizzie. Thank you so much. Oh my gosh. Oh, Lizzie, thank you so much. Oh, that's so pretty. And I think she sent some art too. Oh, wow. Tile, where's Holly? We're gonna have to find Holly now, you guys. Everybody is so excited about finding Holly. We have Agent Noodles here. And look at this. Look at this. Oh, we're gonna have to find Holly. This is gonna be really awesome. We're gonna find her because you guys are all looking for her. This is gonna be really cool. So thank you so much, Lissy. That is just completely amazing. And then we are down to our last letter from Oklahoma. And let's see how this snail mail ends today. I'm blown away. I always feel like I'm gonna curl up in a little corner and just kind of like squee over my treasures for a while, like a little happy cat. All right, ooh, there's definitely some artwork here. Look at the colors. All right. Dear Seri, my name is Alexis. Alexis. I am in fourth grade and love social studies. I am homeschooled and I love making videos. You inspire me so much that I have 2 YouTube channels. By the way, I'm the one who suggested Wrenn the Wolf's name in Wolf Quest 2.7. My favorite episodes are Slime Rancher, Horse Haven, and Wolf Quest 2.7. Love, Alexis. Ah, thank you. Thank you so much, Alexis. Oh, wow. Look at all the drawings. Oh my gosh, there's so many drawings and so, just like all of the little pieces with plants everywhere. That makes me so happy. Oh my gosh, and I'm so glad that Wolf Quest is so popular. Slime Rancher has like a huge following right now. Slime Rancher is just amazing. I really hope we can keep that going for a bit longer. And then we've got Moon Dancer, we've got Rain with the lucky hair, Karine, who is one of our horses, one of my favorite horses from Horse Haven, and a Tabby Slime. Right here, look at that, you guys. Still scaring away all the poor chickadees. And then, oh, here's Moon Dancer. So here's another drawing of Moon Dancer here. What awesome lines. Alexis, this is amazing. So thank you so much. Oh, wow. I cannot wait to add this to my scrapbook. Thank you. Thank you guys so much. I know we went a bit long this time. There was just a lot more mail than usual, and that's always a fantastic thing from the bottom of my heart, thank you to everybody who has sent something in, to everybody who just watches and watches our community share its happiness. I hope we can give you some of that kindness, that creativity, that excitement about the world that you could just take as your like little energy seeds or and grow them into whatever you need them to be. So I know that didn't make a lot of sense. It kind of was a sloppy metaphor, but you know what I mean. Just, I hope you guys can take away some of this joy and excitement that got sent to us and bring it into your own lives. That's what this really unique, special community and the connection that we build here is all about. And I hope you all have a wonderful day, and just thank you all so much for the amazing snail mail. And I cannot wait to see you guys next time. So have a fantastic day, you guys, and I'll see you guys then. Bye-bye.